Oh, guys, nothing. I mean, lately I've been questioning what my whole life is about. It's really giving me Cirrus.
What's Cirrus?
Oh, well, it's Yiddish for a kind of aggravation you don't want to know.
Oh, come on, it can't be that bad.
You know what, I've been wondering if maybe I should just, you know, just forget about it, just give it all up. You know, forget about men and a career, and just go join a convent or something.
A convent?
Yeah.
Are
yeah, why not?
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Come with me right now.
Whoa, wait. Where are we going?
Oh, I think I know exactly what you need.
Come on.
Okay, Iris. What's your plan?
Well, first we have to get our hands on that document of sale that Max supposedly signed.
You don't think he did? I thought you saw it.
Well, it looked very authentic, but that's what a forgery is, isn't it? I mean, a good one. And we have to get hold of it, and we have to prove that it is what it is, which is a forgery, and then we can stop Jake and Spencer from taking over this company, because I've got a feeling that that is the only bit of so-called proof they've got.
So how am I supposed to get a hold of this document?
Simple. You seduce him. Jake's always had a weakness for beautiful Corey women.
Oh, you can't be serious.
Well, you don't have to actually do the deed, you know. I mean, that would be carrying family loyalty too far, but you could just lead him on, couldn't you, until you get your hands on his evidence?
I love it, Iris.
You do?
No, I don't. But, you know, this is kind of refreshing because the way you've been talking lately, I was afraid that we lost the old Iris to an all-new model with all-new standards.
Don't be such a bore, Amanda. You know I'd do it myself if I could, but I just... Jake McKinnon just turns myself.
Oh, right, whereas I find him wildly attractive.
I'd be disgusted if you did, but you used to be friends, so surely you can do it.
Forget it.
Oh, come on, we can just keep it on train.
I said drop it, Iris. It's not funny anymore.
At least you can think about it.
Look what I found in the elevator, schmoozing with a few of the board members.
Yes, well, I think I have enough votes for the board to authorize an independent investigation. Now, is that Taps I hear playing for Rachel and the Corey machine or what?
Jake, as soon as the board finds out that it was you who's been creating these lies and rumors, I'm sure they won't be on your side, Taps. Do you think you could show Mr. McKinnon out of here?
Jake, this is still Rachel's office.
Not for long. Do you think that I can fit Jake McKinnon, chairman and CEO, in that door right there?
Jesus, we're having a meeting here.
And what would be the agenda, Amanda? How to torpedo Jake and Spencer? I have one word for you. Forget about it.
Would somebody please try and find an exterminator and get that pest out of here?
No, Iris, I'm going to be bugging you for years to come. It's the phone.
Excuse me.
Yeah, hello? Maggie? No, wait, calm down. Yeah, I'll get there as soon as I can.
What is it? Paulina was rushed to the hospital.
What happened?
Is it serious?
No, Maggie sounded really
sick. I told you she was sick!
Look, Iris, why don't you stay here with Cass and you deal with this, and I'm gonna go to the hospital.
I'm going with you.
No, Jake, you know, you're the last person she wants to see right now.
Tell me what happened in the jungle.
I got this fever, and Ian helped me.
Were the symptoms the same?
The headache wasn't this bad.
Show me exactly where the pain is centered.
It starts at the back and then it just shoots all over. And when it gets really intense, it makes me dizzy.
She's spiking a fever. I can feel it
Jake's
with my hand.
Jake's fault. Ian, help me.
Listen, draw a set of blood cultures, get a spinal tap and an MRI.
What's the diagnosis?
I'm not sure, but unless we hurry, the only way we're going to find out is an autopsy.
Jenna, I was only kidding. I didn't mean that I wanted to join a convent and become a you-know-what little thingy.
That's okay. You don't have to be embarrassed. Many of my friends are nuns.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
This is where I went to school. This is where I studied and lived before Felicia adopted me, and a lot of the girls have taken their vows. Now they're nuns, so we've kept in touch, and here we are.
You know, I know that I said I need more meaning in my life, but I'm really not sure about this God stuff.
Well, it's okay, because you don't have to be religious here. You can just relax. You gotta admit it's peaceful, right?
You know, I was, never really big on religion, you know? I mean, my dad being Jewish and my mother being Catholic, I mean, we didn't know whether to go to temple on Saturday or church on Sunday.
Jenna?
Don't worry.
Hi, Mother Superior. It's so good to see you.
Oh, I thought it was you. I saw you from my office window.
You did. I've brought a friend that I wanted to introduce you to, okay?
Oh.
Okay. Mother Superior, this is my friend Brett Gardner.
How do you do, Brett?
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Brett's having some problems right now, and I was kind of hoping maybe she could stay here.
Hmm.
Me stay here?
Mm-hmm.
In a convent?
Any news?
No, I can't get through to John Hudson, and of course the damn switchboard can't give me any information about Paulina's condition.
Amanda will call as soon as she knows anything.
Yes, if she's not driven to distraction by Jake McKinnon.
Paulina is getting the best medical attention. I'm sure everything will be fine.
I wish I could say the same about Corey.
Have you heard from Rachel yet today?
No, not yet.
That's really strange. She usually calls or leaves a number where she can be reached by now.
She's not been much help, is she, traveling around the country like this?
She's still trying to find evidence to exonerate Mac.
Oh, yes. Well, she hasn't come up with anything yet. Cass, we just can't stand by and wait for her to save the day. We have to come up with something.
If we are going to refute these charges, we're going to have to do some serious digging into Mac's past.
I won't allow my father's name to be vilified, Cass. You can have access to anything that you need.
Good. If Mac actually did finance Corey Publishing with the funds he got from double-crossing his partners and selling off the rainforest, there's got to be some record of it on the Corey books.
Talk to Greenwood in the computer department. Tell him I said you could have carte blanche.
Good. I'll let you know if I find anything.
Yes, I pray to God you don't.
Hey, Cass.
Hank.
How you doing, buddy?
Okay, how you doing?
Good.
Good.
Hi.
I thought I'd stop by on my way to work. See how you're holding up here.
Well, I'm a lot better now that you're here.
And I guess you're still not going to announce our engagement until you have things straight here at Corey.
I hope you don't mind too much, darling. I hope it doesn't affect your plans.
Well, actually, that's what I came here to talk about, my plans.
Yep. The plan. By the fishing camp in Washington.
Yeah, I didn't want that to be another problem.
Well, you know, it is a bit of a problem. Having to decide between the man you love and everything that you hold dear in Bay City.
Oh, I agree. I agree it is a tough decision. I know that.
Hank, I don't know what to do.
Well, I do. I've been doing a lot of soul searching.
And?
And the bottom line is I've decided to let you off.
Moving to Washington without me?
I could.
None of your business. Get the hell out of here. Paulina doesn't want to
leave
it
until I know she's okay.
You want me to have you thrown out?
I have just as much right to be here as you do.
Okay, we'll let Paulina decide that.
Look, how is she? Is there any news?
No, we're still waiting.
There's something I tried to tell you. There was something wrong with her last night.
What do you mean? What last night?
I went to the video loft, man. She was there, passed out. I drove her home. I tried to warn Iris and Amanda, and neither one of them
would
listen to
me. Paulina claimed she was fine. She said she was upset about Ian, but of course Jake made her more upset.
I was just trying to help out, all right?
John, how was Paulina?
Is it serious? You're right.
Her headache was my immediate concern, but now she's spiking a fever to dangerously high levels. I've got her on a broad-spectrum antibiotic.
Okay, well, what's wrong with her? I mean,
I don't know.
Will the antibiotic bring down the fever?
Without a specific diagnosis, I can't be sure.
John, come on. Would you just level with us? How bad is it?
If you're asking if Paulina's condition is serious, the answer is yes. Very.
I mean, I thought Bay City General was state-of-the-art. Can't they do some tests?
I've ordered a spinal tap and a whole battery of diagnostic tests.
When will we get the results?
I'll let you know when they're available, but in the meantime, perhaps you can answer some questions. We can narrow down the possibilities.
Yeah, whatever you need.
Paulina mentioned that when she was in San Cristobal, she had some similar symptoms. And do you know anything about that?
No, I had
she
no idea.
Never mentioned that. Must have been when she went in the jungle with, Ian.
Yeah, well, maybe we should ask Ian. He would know.
Shut up, Maggie, all right? Ian is in solitary. There's no way you can talk to him. Now, I'm sorry, John, but I was in San Cristobal with her. I can help you with anything that you need.
Didn't Paulina's mother die shortly after she gave birth?
Yeah, Paulina went around town asking people how her mom died, and found out that her mother died of a fever.
She couldn't have caught the same kind of fever in the same kind of bug in the jungle. I mean, could it? Could it be a virus?
It's possible. It could be some kind of bacteria. Rainforests are teeming with all kinds of microbes to which Paulina would have no natural immunity.
Yeah, but just being exposed to bacteria can't be fatal, can it?
Given her symptoms, it looks like she might have cerebral meningitis, which is very serious. Getting worse. Come on, Jake, we have to find some answers.
Okay.